Thank you, Senator Padilla. Senator Welch.
Thank you, Madam Chair. And all those California reforms, I think we have them in Vermont. They're working pretty good. But, you know, to Mr. Fontes, to Mr. Schmidt, Mr. Benna, to Mr. Farley and Ms. Howard, I want to express my gratitude. You've got a hard job, but what I heard in the testimony each of you gave was your job has clear definition. Make it as easy as possible for people to vote and make certain everybody's vote is counted. And who would have thought that turns into a situation where a person's dog would be poisoned? I mean, it's really, really terrible. All of us here right now were present on January 6th. And of course, that's not really ended, is what you're saying. But what I find so inspiring about each of you is your dedication to respecting the will of the people you serve. Let them decide. It's as simple as that. And make it as easy as possible for them to vote. And that's why it's dismaying and discouraging to hear the stories about how people that work with you, and I'm sure you're really concerned about every day, and they're close to being volunteers, many of them, in Vermont, most are, get threatened or have their dog poisoned. That's just really, really astonishing. So I want to just express to you my gratitude because it's your kind of leadership and civic sense of responsibility that has to overtake the folks who think that they can win an election by things that they do after. But I'll start with you, Mr. Fontes. What can we do? You mentioned, I want you to elaborate a little bit about this, about the importance of people being held accountable who do, in fact, interfere with election workers. Just explain a little bit why you think that ultimately would be beneficial. Go ahead.
Well, Senator, thank you for the question. Accountability is always, I mean, that's foundational to
right.
the way that civil society works. We have a criminal justice system that holds folks accountable for criminal behavior. We have a civil justice system that holds folks for civil penalties if they do wrongs there.
So just the basics.
There's no reason in the world why we shouldn't hold people accountable who are attacking our democracy through the very people who are administering our democracy. And so the notion of accountability and personal responsibility for your bad actions, for your interference with
right.
basic civil duties. I think it's crazy that we wouldn't want, or that someone might think that we wouldn't want to hold people accountable for threatening
right.
civil servants.
Well, thank you. I agree with that. And Mr. Schmidt, you've been talking a little bit about the difficulty of recruiting and retaining folks that help monitor our elections. What are some of the specific things you think we could do that might help there? And how much of this do you think is a result of the kind of fear and intimidation? Because in Vermont, we don't have that many poll workers, but it's folks who have a little flexibility in their schedule. They show up and they feel really good. They're seeing their neighbors. They feel like they're contributing to our democracy by doing their part, and they enjoy it. But that's not the same if when they show up, they get harassed and threatened. So maybe you could give us some suggestions on how we can change availability.
Yeah, I think it's a couple of things. It's important that we support them and also that they feel supported. And that when they are under attack or being unfairly maligned in some way, that others speak out regardless of party. And I think that's a very important part of all of this. Regardless of party, to defend the people who are responsible for running elections and being so irresponsibly maligned. That's not necessarily about dollars, although dollars have played an important role. It's not about changing laws in and of themselves to protect one person because of their role or another, although that also plays an important role. It's also, I think, to make sure that they are valued and supported and not just
yeah.
left to hang out there
yeah.
In the face of all of this ugliness.
And Mr. Benna, you Nebraska, we all love Senator Fisher. She's bragging about Nebraska all the time. It's small-town values. I mean, you've heard some of your colleagues talk about the dog being poisoned. That letter, Ms. Howard, you wrote. I hope, are you having those kind of challenges in Nebraska as well?
Actually, we're not.
Good.
Actually, we're not. We, in 2020, many of our poll workers wanted to stay home because of the uncertainty, and we started what was called the Step Up campaign, which allowed to say, give your parents and grandparents a break and serve in this election. And what we saw from that was that not only after 2020 did the parents and grandparents come back, but the kids and grandkids wanted to serve along with them. And so we have a great bench of people wanting to be poll workers. Not to say that, you know, people are going to leave elections or and what have you, but for our election officials that have left and retired, a great number of them come back to consult their replacement. And between that and the training we do at the Secretary of State's office, we're very lucky to have the county election officials and a backbench of poll workers to support them.
So. That's fantastic. It's like it's intergenerational. Thank you very much. I yield back.
Thank you very much, Senator.